At the bleep of an incoming text, she checks her mobile phone. It's Jaymi, sending her the coordinates of the server farm. She'd almost forgotten why she is really here. And with this memory comes the further understanding that she is way too transcendent a beast to be wasted on standard chase scenes through meat space, and ersatz meat space at that. Such staple devices are not her style at all. She was built for subtler things, surely. Okay, then. She's done with acting like nothing more than a sensuous embodiment of her maker's unfocused explorations around this new West Side landscape. Jaymi's heart was never quite in this LAX mission, despite his best intentions for it, as the Platinum Raven now perceives. It is time to graduate into being a more bloodlessly conceptual weapon, thank you. It is time for her real mission. So, she flits across LAX's western half, through those liminal, mineral spaces that so become her, and slips out through its perimeter, across Pershing Drive, and up the lonely bare slope of Sandpiper Street. Just beyond the top of the slope, two little El Segundo blue butterflies dart up out of the wild buckwheat and dance about her, one blue and one a golden brown. She blows them a kiss. Ahead of her is a low structure with a single closed door. She gives the door a gentle push. It swings open to reveal a small lobby, at the end of which she sees Amber standing in contemplation of the downward-pointing arrow on a button beside a pair of lift doors.